I take medication to help take the edge off, I guess you could say. But sometimes those medications make me feel like a zombie. I've been taking them for over 15 years. I don't know. Sometimes, I mean, I feel spacey all the time. Sometimes I forget what I'm gonna say. I forget where I put things. It's been a battle ever since I was 15 years old. Sometimes I just cry and ask God, is like, God, why can't you give me a brain that actually functions, actually works right? I pray to God. I talked to my grandma that passed away about 3 years ago, and I believe she's around. I believe she helps me. I'll cry and cry and cry. And sometimes I feel like someone's giving me a hug, and it just like all that pain just goes away. And the thing is like some people, they look at you and they don't understand. You try to explain it to them. Some people understand. Some people also like to take advantage of people who have disabilities. Like, oh, that's an easy target. I can take anything I want from them. They won't do anything. Well, I suffer from bipolar 2 disorder, which means I have high days where I'm manic. And if you don't know what manic is, it's where you have these really high, like, I can do anything. I can write a book. I can paint a picture. I can sell make $1 million movie. But sometimes you have those really lows where you're just like, I'm a worthless piece of crap. I don't deserve to live. I don't want to live. I don't want to get out of bed. Nobody likes me. Nobody loves me. And it's constant. It's like 2-3 days you'll feel like you're on top of the world. And it 2-3 days you'll just be in that slump. Sometimes it lasts longer. Sometimes it doesn't. But it's a cycle. And you know when you're high, you're like, oh, I know it's coming. I know it's going to, next couple days, I'm going to, pew, I'm not going to want to get out of bed. I'm not going to want to go to work. And, you know, it starts to affect your, of course, it starts to affect your work life and the people that you work for, or the people that you work with. You know, that if they don't understand, if they don't go through the same things, and you're always constantly wondering what people are thinking about you, at least me anyway, with the anxiety. I was diagnosed with like panic attacks, anxiety, so I have to take medicine every day. The medicine I was taking, it works, but sometimes it gives you like zombie states, or really, really tired and unmotivated, irritated. I'm not saying this about all medications, you know, you gotta find the right medications to balance you out, which I think I found the right medication, but sometimes I'm like, I found it, and then it works for a while, and then it stops working. But I just wish that there was more people to talk to, which I do have a lot of people to talk to about it, but I just wish to spread more awareness about people who are sick. You know, try to understand that what they're going through. I mean, you might not understand, you know, be in their situation or in their head, but people who have disability or anxiety or depression, it's real. It's real as if you broke your leg, your arm, got punched in the face, it hurts. And I just want to bring awareness that if y'all ever want to talk, you know, or hang out, that I'm here, you know, vice versa. And I just wish and pray and hope that everybody has a nice day, and hopefully I'll be able to bring more awareness. And you should spread the awareness of mental health, because I know a lot of people are suffering, especially when you get your phone out and you're looking at it and like, oh, something blew up here, there's a war over here. And you always hear about people committing suicides or people freaking out in restaurants and, you know, attacking each other. It's just like, why don't we just put the phone down for a while? Why don't we just go outside and breathe the fresh air and meditate and thank God that we're still alive? Thank God that we have a roof over our heads. Some people don't have roofs over their heads. Some people are starving. We got to be thankful for what we have. every day, every second. You know, I thank God I have my family still. You know, people pass away. I've lost a couple people. I've lost my best friend, my dog. You're like, oh, it's just a dog. Maybe to you, but not to me. That was my best friend. Her name was Precious. I had her for 16 years, and she got old. You know, I had to put her to sleep, and that was a hard time. My grandma, you know, you always think your grandparents are going to be around forever, and you don't visit them as much as you should. And you're like, oh, they'll be here forever. I can always visit them some other time. But they pass away, and you're just like, I wish I would have spent more time with them. You know, went over there and just hung out. My grandma, she had a garden, and she was in there at her garden every day. You'd drive by her house, honk at her, and she'd be waving. You know, she'd be out in her yard every single day. Now it's just, you know, the grass is overgrown. There's no flowers. All her knickknacks and stuff are gone. And it's kind of hard, you know, and it really is hard, but I know she's with me. I feel her presence. I've witnessed things that you'd have to witness for yourself or else you wouldn't believe them. But I'm ready to move on with my life. I'm ready to do the best that I can. I'm ready to take that step forward in my, you know, my, I guess you would call it a career. It is a career. It is a career. You know, I'm doing better than I've ever done in my life. I sat in a hole. You know, I was stuck for like 10 years repeating a cycle. Let's, you know, go to the bar, smoke weed, and do all sorts of stupid stuff that I shouldn't have been doing. And I woke up one day, I was 28 years old. I remember this, plain as day. I'm like, Daniel, what have you done with your life? You said you were going to do great things. You said you wanted to accomplish this. You wanted to be an actor. You wanted to be a director, a writer. And I hit rock bottom. I'm like, nobody loves me. Nobody cares about me. Like, I failed myself. I failed my family. And I just look up and I was like, God, help me. Help me. What do I do? And it's just like this force hit me. And it's like, Daniel, get off your ass. Do it. Don't procrastinate. Don't sit there. Get up and do it. Do something with your life. You still got time. You're not too old. You're never too old to fulfill your dreams. Well, I don't know. But I think we should all just get up, dust ourselves off, and hit your goals. Hit it with a baseball bat. Knock it out of the park. Because you only got one life. You may have messed up. You may have done drugs. You may have went to jail. You may have done some bad things in life, but there's always room for a second chance, and I think people should give other people their second chance. That's what I'd want in life, is like, I mess up, you know, it's like, I'm sorry. Always give people a chance, you know, but don't let them take advantage of you, because they definitely will take advantage of you. Let them help, you know, help them, but you can only help so much. They have to help themselves too. But that's really all I got to say for today. I mean, I just thought I'd get out and or get the camera out and have a short video or whatever. But if y'all just stick to your dreams, stick to the vision, go for the vision, do it. I love you guys, and I hope you have a wonderful day. So peace out. Read a book. Go outside. Breathe some air. Who knows? You might have a good day. Hopefully.